Hello, my name is Bastian Kuhn, and today I'm going to show you how to secure your CheckMK web interface. For that, we're going to need a certificate. I'm going to show you how to create it, how to create a private key, how to create a signing request for this certificate, and later on how to implement it into the Apache configuration. At first, we're going to check if you already have a secure connection. You can see that in your browser with this little icon. And because of the red border here, you can see the page currently is not secure. So let's change that. The first thing now, I'm going to generate a private key and a certificate signing request. We should do that always on the server so that the private key stays safe there. The first thing now I'm going to do is going to generate the private key. I'm going to use the open SSL command, gen RSA. Out, I enter the key name and the number of bits. That's the first thing. And a second, I'm going to need the signing request. That's the file I'm going to send out later to the department or to the website who creates the key. Again, it's with the open SSL command. This time, request, new. I enter my private key and the name of the request file. Now it asks me some questions. The answers to these questions are normally supplied by your SSL department or the department who generates the keys for you. In this case, I'm going to use my data. The field of the common name here is the most important one, because here you're going to enter which is your certificate name. Make sure that you have the full domain name, like stated here. Also, I want to give you the advice that if you request a certificate for exactly this name, www.monitoringlan would not work. So you here basically need the exact name. So that's then basically is. And we now send out this request file to the department or website. After then you receive the certificate file, you can go on and implement it into Apache. In my example, I have the certificate. I got even the full chain for the certificate. And that's just the private key I generated before. The first step then is to copy it to the correct directory. First, the private PAM needs to go to etc, SSL, and private. The certificate goes to etc, SSL, certs. Also, I'm going to put the chain file into the same directory. That's the first step. And the second part now is to change the paths in Apache. For that, we go to etc, Apache 2. If you're using Red Hat, the folder would be etc, httpd. And there we need to gonna look for the virtualhost configuration file for the SSL. The path of this depends on your Linux distribution. In Ubuntu, like here, you can find it inside available. There you're gonna find the default ssl.conf. If you don't have this directory or this file, we need to gonna look for the this part here, virtualhost, and the port 443, which is the port for the HTTPS. There, we're gonna search for the part of the SSL certificate file, certificate key file, and here in this case, the certificate chain file. What I'm gonna do now is just replace it with mine. We had the certificate.pem. Here we had the private.pem. And here, just need to remove the hash here. We have the third chain.pem. The next step is just to enable the site. For that, we have the r2n site command, where we enable default SSL. And the second step, maybe the SSL module is missing. For that, we just enable r2n mod SSL. And finally, we restart Apache. After this reload, we should be able to query our page, which HTTPS, and it looks fine now. The log here is intact and have a secure connection. If you run in any problems, there's a little command you can use to get help. It's the Apache 2CTL config test. So for example, if Apache isn't starting, you just run this config test. And this config test is going to give you information. For example, if you entered the wrong directory for the certificates or something else is wrong, for example, the SSL certificate missing. I hope this gave you a little insight how to secure your CheckMK web interface. For even more information, we linked you an article from our blog. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. See you next time.